Hello, 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 and welcome to my new OpenTTD challenge series. OpenTTD is the open version of the mid-90s game Transport Tycoon Deluxe. OpenTTD is still being developed today. In fact, we are starting on the brand new release from beginning of this month. This game has an incredible following of dedicated players and developers, and I'm one of the dedicated players. And I wanted to make a series with difficult and fun challenges where you people can participate. So the start save game for the series is available for everybody, and you can find the link to it in the description below. Now, this challenge is about starting in the year 1701. The standard game doesn't have any vehicles at that time, but some new GRFs do. And therefore, we are starting in 1701 with sailing ships. I will go over the other different new GRFs and settings we used in this game, but for now, let's start the game. Alright, so welcome to the game. First off, let's start by changing the colors and the whole company stuff. Let's start with a new face that isn't a dictator. Ooh, that's creepy. let's see. That's better. Colors, we want orange and purple. Manager name, we are not Mr. Green. Probably a very nice guy, but not me. Then we are raw transport. The HQ we build later. Let's first start with earning some money. So let's open this window and pin it. Okay, so we have a loan of maximum 100,000. This isn't much because the boats itself cost 30,000. So we can only have 3 boats at the start. So we have to be careful with what we are transporting and with what we're gonna make our money with. So let's first start with looking at the cargo payment rates. Let's forget a few things that we are not gonna do at this point. So these are our options. Well, coal is paid the best, as is wood, but they are both paid only one way. So if you go back, you are not getting paid. So it's not really fair to say that these are best paid, because mail and passengers are paid both ways. So, well, passengers aren't paid as well at this point. So let's start off with mail, and after that we can do coal and wood. But let's start making money with mail. Let's see, so opening the map, and let's turn off the town names. We need 2 towns above 1,000, so we can do either here. Well, that one is a big one, but that one isn't. And I see, here, this is 1,000, and let's start here. So we're gonna make a connection between these two. Let's unpause the game and let's start constructing. Let's see, that is not a big area. Let's put it right there. Depot next to it. Let's put a buoy in between just in case. And let's see, what's the best catchment area? Well, I think we're gonna do it here. So let's put a depot there. And let's order some new ships. All cargo types, no, we want mail. Buy and refit. Then you can go full load right there. How is your reliability? Yeah, 56%, that's not much. So let's send you on a forced service. Then go to the buoy. Go to the other docks and full load there. Shall we do another service? Yeah, let's do that, just in case. And return to the buoy to go back. So, there. To there, to there, to there, to there, and back. Okay, so that is correct. Let's send you on your way. Let's start on this one as well with another one. And let's clone another one for this side. I cloned them with shared orders, by the way. That's holding control. So we only have to change the orders for one. And then it changes for all of them. You can start at that dock on that side. So we pretty much burned through our money. And let's see how much they are making. They are loading at the moment. This side will probably go faster. But let's take a look on how much they are earning. Which now gives me a great opportunity to talk about the settings and the new GRFs. So let's do that now. Alright, let me talk about the settings and new GRFs. First the settings, and these are settings that should make a difference to the challenge. So the starting year is 1701 and everything is set to metric, Celsius and driving on the right. Auto renew for vehicles is turned on and service intervals are set to 10% for all vehicle types. Inflation is turned on, the infrastructure maintenance costs are on and running and construction costs are set to medium. Trains are forbidden to make 90 degree turns and the maximum length of trains and the maximum station spread are both set to 18. Disasters and recessions are both on and vehicle breakdowns are set to normal. Towns control the noise level on airports and the town growth speed is set back to slow. We can have multiple similar industries per town and the distribution for all passengers and cargo are set to asymmetric. All these settings are hopefully enough to balance the game but give us a good challenge. Okay, then the new GRFs. These are additions or replacement to the base game. First we have the sailing ships that give us sailing ships until we can use other motorized vehicles. The OpenGFX Plus, trees, trains, road vehicles, landscapes and industries are enhancements on the OpenGFX graphic set. Then the OpenGFX Stations gives us more customizable station tiles and the OpenGFX Airports gives the ability to rotate airports when placing. Housing as industry gives us the ability to place an apartment complex as an industry in cities. These apartments give us passengers and mail and accept passengers, mail and goods. Beach as industry gives us beaches as an industry that provide and accept passengers. The beach objects are needed for this. 2cc cargo trams gives us cargo trams from 1872 forward and 2cc trams gives us passenger trams from 1872 forward. 2cc wagons are train wagons to give us more choice in those and Roadhog gives us additional road vehicles. The Vactrain Set and hover vehicles are so we can get more vehicles after 2050. That are all the new GRFs that we are using here. You can also play along with this game and you can find the link to the save file in the description. If you have any questions, remarks or suggestions, please leave a comment below and also if you enjoyed the video, please leave a like. I don't know how many episodes of this series I'm going to make, but be sure to subscribe and turn notifications on so you don't miss out on any episode. That all being said, let's get back to the game. Alright, so we are back. And the first ship is about to get in, so let's zoom in a bit. Let's see how much this one is going to make us. Probably 3,000, something like that. Hopefully 3,000. And they are pretty slow, so let's start by fast forwarding the game a bit. Ooh, 4,000. Wow, that's nice. That's nice. Oh, the second one is already coming in as well. So this is going quite well. That's the first breakdown. Reliability is 5% up at this point. And they are making quite a bit of money. We have 10,000, so we can't do anything yet. Let's take a look. There are 96 or 100. Well, they all want to go to Barnwald, but that's obvious because we only have one station. So we can do... Do we have any more? Not much in the neighborhood. We could transfer some from here to there, but that's probably too costly at this point. And we can repay our first loan. I will be doing this throughout the game because the loan interest is 4%. So anytime I can repay, I will repay. And let's see how much. 50 bags, and you can hold 50. And here are 90 bags. So we could do with one other ship. Okay, but we have to wait till we have 30,000 again. We are already in the new year. Okay, so all the ships are ungrouped at this point. Let's group them real quick. I like to group them, especially with ships, because in a while we get separate passenger and cargo ships. So for now it's very handy to have them in separate categories, so you can replace them separate as well. Plus you can see per category or per group, you can see how much they are earning. So that's why I always do this. Let's make another one for... Oh, let's not do that here. And let's do it properly. And that's again the wrong one. There, and then coal. That will be the next one. And we have enough money for a new ship, so let's clone you with shared or with shared orders. And let's send you on your way. And that is gonna annoy me quite a bit, so let's turn vehicles off for the moment. The more we have, the more things we get, so... Okay, so we have four going now. We only have 90 here, 42 there. So let's leave this for now. And let's start looking for a new town. So we have two big ones here. And they are quite close together. But perhaps we can do the following. If we do this... Yeah, and on this side, this covers more. Okay, let's put a depot in the middle, and we almost have enough for a new ship. So let's start with mail again. Passengers, we're gonna do very, very much later if we have enough money. So let's go to you and full load. Then let's service, and let's full load at that side as well. And we don't have to service on the way back because the start reliability now is 74%, so that's pretty good. We can close you, and let's see how much this one is going to make us. Well, it first has to full load 50 bags. We got a pretty decent coverage on this one. And due to the power of editing, it is full loaded in a matter of seconds. And it is on its way to the other dock. We can almost repay another 20 grand. Yep, let's do that. And, well, not much, but decent. And it costs... 1300 a year, so well, it will make money. Let's put this one. This is ship number 5 in mail, and we can clone it so we can have another one. Wrong buttons. That one. And let's send it on its way. So we have two here. Do we have another town nearby? Right here. So let's take this one as well. Ooh, that's also a tricky catchment. Let's do it like this. Okay. Depot. Let's put one buoy right in the middle. And now we have to wait till we have 30k so we can buy a new ship. Alright, so we are quite on our way to making some decent amount of money. We can almost have a new ship, so let's prepare. Let's take that out. Let's clone this one. In there. Ah, I cloned it with shared orders. That is not correct. So stop sharing and delete all. You go full load right there. Go to the nearest depot, then go to the buoy, and then do we do this one or that one? Let's do this one. Full load at this one. Go to the depot again, back to the buoy, and back to there. There, and back. Yeah, okay, that's correct. So let's start that one off. We are in another new year. How much money are we making? Well, yeah, not any at this point. But we are starting off quite well in the new year. So let's see how much this one is going to make. And again, by the power of editing, we are on our way in a matter of seconds. So we can repay some of the loan. Let's follow you. How much are you going to make? The reliability is shot through the roof for all of them. So that is pretty good. Hopefully it will go to 90, but well, I don't know. Let's see. I believe that every time we force them to service, the reliability also becomes better. But there is a cap on it, and I don't know what that is for this boat. So, well, what do we say for this distance? 5,000-6,000, I think, something like that. Let's see. Transfer. And only 4,000. Why did we transfer? Oh, it's doing that automatically. Yeah. Okay. So we have the bags that go via Putthead, and then to here, and likewise otherwise. So it puts a transfer for any passenger or any bag of mail. Yeah, see? So there are 40 bags that want to go to Taburg, and 40 bags that want to go to there. So any bag that goes through here to there will give a transfer, and then this one will get more money. Should get more money, at least. Well, in that case, perhaps we can better remove this one and go to there. It should be the same. Yeah. Okay, let's do that. I think that will earn us more money. Let's clone you. Oh, let's borrow some money first. That would be nice. And can we do one another? Nope. We have to wait a bit. And we are already in 1705. So they are full loading. I'll probably leave it at two ships at this point. And we'll come back to this again. Let's see how the other ones are doing. How much do we have waiting here? Ooh, that's a lot. And how much here? Nothing. Okay, so we're gonna leave this like we have now. How much money are you making? 11,000. Okay, so they started making less money because they have to wait here. Okay. Ooh, these are nicely close. Okay, so catchment area. Well, let's do it like that. And this one, that's... yeah, there. Okay. So one there and one there. And let's buy a boat. Yeah, we are transporting mail, so buy and refit. Then you can go full load there. Let's go to the depot, then full load there, and that's it. And there we go. We can have another one, so let's clone this one. And you start at that one. Oh, this one is loading up quite nice. This one as well. I think we can start looking at coal mines. No longer accepts goods. That doesn't matter. That does not matter. So let's search for and disable this, a coal mine and a power station. Okay, so let's see. We need a coal mine and a power station both on the edge of the water, because we don't want to alter any terrain yet, because that is quite expensive. These two are too far away from the edge. I think I found one. Is this on the edge? Passengers coal. Yes, and this one is on the edge. Yep, here we go. So let's place a station right there and a station right there. Depot in the middle. And let's order a ship. But we are moving coal. So let's borrow some money, buy and refit. And this should now be more, yes, 50,000 coal. So your orders go to full out there, then go to the nearest depot, and then offload there. Well, it offloads automatically, but that one is implied. Let's go there. How much? Oh, the production isn't that high, but perhaps we can up it a bit. Let's order another ship and send it on its way. We can have one more, in fact. So let's do that. And let's sort these out, because they are coal ships. And we are again in a new year. We already in 1707. So 74%. And let's keep an eye out on the ratings with this one. The higher the ratings, the more they are going to produce, the more we are earning. So let's repay the loan. How much are you going to make? Well, I'm pretty nailed it with my predictions. 3,500. Let's say that. Wow. I am right. I'm learning this game. And this probably will be higher because this one weighted a bit. So
36.
Oh no, the same. Oh, okay. Oh well. Okay, so how much is waiting there? Nothing at the moment. We have three ships. Let's put another one on there. So there's always one waiting at the station. And perhaps it's even wise to do another one. This one is almost full, and this one has just started. This one is coming up. Yeah, well, if it ups its production one bit, we have stopped waiting there. So let's do another one just in case. Can't hurt. Let's do that. And they will space them out themselves. Okay, do we have any more coal mines nearby? Well, we have one here, but that is a bit off the water. Let's see, how much does this cost us? 8 grand, so that's fine. And this one will cost us 600. And I think with that we have in fact a new line. Yes, we do. So let's clone one of these without sharing the orders. And remove you and put in a full load right there. So they will go through there. And I think, yeah, we need a buoy here and a buoy there. So before we get there, go to the buoy, to the second buoy, and after we went there, back, and there. And I think let's place a ship depot here, and let's force them. That's the buoy in, that's the buoy out. So after the buoy, go to that depot. It's full loading, yes. Let's clone you right away. Send them both on their way. In fact, we can have some more. Let's see, this production, oh, this is quite high production, so we probably need some more ships for this one. So they are on their way. Let's send the next one out. Repay some of the loan. Okay, let's send this one out as well. And let's see, the first one is right there. Yeah, we need more because it will stack up at this point. So let's borrow everything, clone it. And we need 10 grand more. Come on, you can do it. Well, and it's broken down. I must say that the breakdowns are pretty low, so that's quite good. Okay, so let's follow you closely. And let's see what this boat is going to make us. But that will be in the next episode. So we're gonna pause the game right here. Thank you so much for watching. I hope you enjoyed this episode. If you have any suggestions, remarks or questions, then leave a comment below. And also leave a like, subscribe and hit the notification bell to keep up to date with my videos. Have a great day and see you next time. Bye bye.